will not happen. Pastor Wanga Madori told me, affliction will not happen the second time. It's actually a theme for the whole month. Affliction, power. And you know, Lacazette wanted to start that thing again. That actually goal he scored the last time.
Yeah, man.
He didn't agree this time.
This time, the Reds didn't allow. At all. So, yes, well done.
Thank you.
You spoiled 100% this thing.
Yeah, two games so out of two, 100%. Good morning.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. You don't need that idea.
United 4 days. If people are talking about football,
we don't have to talk about it.
We just listen.
You don't talk anymore.
We have Operation 2050.
Yes.
Hey. United fans.
You don't talk about football anymore.
No.
All right. So let's get into the headlines. Today I want to start with citybusinessnews.com. So the website that I'll start with today. It says over 600 bags of maize harvested from city farms. Mm-hmm. Over 600 bags of maize harvested from city farms. And there is an aerial photo of the city management team with Vivian Kai Lokowain ready to fight. Collecting maize. Powerful. Also, Bank of Ghana maintains policy rate for third consecutive time at 14.5%. Other stories. Ghana's debt stock up by 43 billion cedis. And pay fuel suppliers regularly to ensure continuous power supply, IPPs, to government. Now, if you go to citynewsroom.com, the lead story there is there's a hidden agenda by persons seeking independent Togo, Western Togo, and this is Intradan. So another one says, members of secessionist group allegedly attack STC, beat up drivers, bend down bus.
Wow.
Eminent persons to EC, involve IPAC in every process. Hear from if you go to myjoyonline.com. Asante Manu, remember your good works on December 7th. Otunfo to Akufo Addo. Also, not every doctor or nurse is a frontline health worker, according to the information minister. Meanwhile, we are talking that Japan is suffering from COVID complications. Lawyers explain his absence in court. And EC says December 2020 poll cannot be manipulated. And finally, on Star News, members of Western Togoland allegedly beat up STC drivers and burned bus. Also, global COVID 19 death toll passes 1 million. 1 million. And other stories. We will name our promised stadium after you, Brekum Queen Mother to Mahama. And of course, as you heard, Otunfo to Akufo-Addo, election 2020, your work will speak for you. Kojo.
Now I'll go to the finder first. Ashanti region gets 1,824 projects. Otunfo says, Asante Man will remember Akufo-Addo's good works on December 7th. You read a story about global COVID-19 deaths crossing 1 million.
1 million.
Now, front page of the finder, Ghana's COVID-19 fight receives global applause.
Mm.
BOGI's economic recovery of up to 2.5%.
Mm-hmm.
RTI coalition laments sluggish implementation of the law. Now, political parties, peace-loving Ghanaians must condemn secessionist group. This is the NPP. Church of Pentecost launches 2020 Agent of Peace campaign.
Mm-hmm.
And there's this issue to do with SGS and GCNet staff. There's an update. Redundant staff triumph again over SGS, GCNet at Labour Commission.
Okay.
Right. The Daily Graphic. President commissions $95 million recycling plant creates 2,300 jobs. Heart disease patients shy away from cardio center, says Dr. Sribo. EC restores majority of missing names on register.
Now, I'll start from the back page of the Ghanaian Times this time, not the front page. Assembly members advocate electoral area common fund. You know, there's a district assembly common fund.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
They want electoral area common fund.
Okay.
To coordinate, to fund developments in their areas.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we will deliver credible voters register in readiness for December 2020 polls. Mm. EC assures. President commissions $95 million Kumasi recycling plant, expected to be the biggest in Africa. Please retrieve ammunition, 2 vehicles from separatist group. Mm-hmm. And Kennedy Japan absent from court due to COVID-19 complications.
The Daily Guide. Asante Man appreciates you. Otunfo blesses Nana. Akufo-Addo opens $95 million waste plant in Kumasi. Voter population 17 million. NPP wants other parties to condemn voter violence. And Mahama Cash reigns at Brekum.
The Chronicle. Your good works will speak for you. Otunfo tells Akufo-Addo. Ken suffering from post-COVID-19 complication, court told. NPP supports, rally support to quell secession in Volta. An interesting story from Kitasi. Residents call for truce in dispute over construction of 120-bed hospital. Now, the story is that the chief wants to build a hospital.
Mm-hmm.
A real estate developer says the land is for him, hmm. and he won't allow the chief to build.
Wow.
Yeah.
The Daily Statesman will remember your good works on December 7th, Otumfo assures Ekufuado on behalf of Asantiman.
Mm.
Ghana gets global applause for COVID-19 fight, and let's condemn separatist activities in Volta region, NPP to political actors.
Okay.
The new crusading guide, Otumfo, is still on the front page. Otumfo hails Ekufuado. Court summons Ken Ejapon's doctor. President lauds Jospon group of companies for building the biggest compost plant in Africa.
Mm.
NDC votes in Volta and Ashanti decline. Governance Research Bureau.
The business analyst. Economy on course for rebound, says the governor of the Bank of Ghana.
Mm-hmm.
Ghana gets crucial competition law and government grapples with fiscal deficit pressures.
Okay.
Now the ABC News. Asantiman will remember your good works on 7th December. Tune forward to President Ekufuado. Missing voters found, just 7,000 left. This is Jean Mensa. We'll develop zongos with model schools, not mortuaries, by Omiya Mox Mahama. And the editorial of the ABC News, Ekufuado's free senior high school game changer.
Mm.
The Business and Financial Times. Policy rates stayed over fiscal threat. Bank of Ghana to provide bullion vans and helicopters for safe transport of cash. President inaugurates $95 million composting and recycling plant in Kumasi.
Mm.
And government to provide 200 million Ghana cedis funding for startups.
Let's get into the details now.
Okay, let's start with the center spread of the Ghanaian Times. President commissions $95 million Kumasi recycling plant.
Mm-hmm.
Kingsley Hope writes that the president, Nana Adodanko Ekufuado, has commissioned a $95 million integrated compost and recycling plant in Kumasi aimed at processing solid waste into reusable material, organic product, and plastics. The $95 million project, which is located at Adeja in the Bosumtwi constituency in the Ashanti region, when completed, will have the capacity of receiving 2,400 tons of solid waste, which is above the daily generation of 1,200 tons of waste in Kumasi.
Mm.
The president said the project is the largest in Africa and Ghana as a whole, comprising of one cubic metric solid waste, a restaurant, a clinic, cafeteria, lecture halls, administration block, a conference hall, and other auxiliary facilities.
Okay.
The compost and recycling plant is part of the Zoom Lion Ghana Limited integrated recycling and compost plant established by the Jospon group of companies to receive, sort, process, and recycle waste.
Fantastic news.
Yes, the Daily Graphic also captures that story. And the executive chairman of the Jospon group of companies, Mr. Joseph Sian Ejepong, expressed gratitude to Ghanaian governments past and present for the support extended to him over the years as he started off as a local business. He said that support had enabled the company, which is Zoom Lion, to survive and also to expand to other parts of the country. He talked about efficient and effective waste management and saying that's the way to go to reduce the pressure on landfill sites and make more land available for development. He also said the facility had been adopted by the Kwame Nkrumah University of Science and Technology, KNUST, as a research center for recycling and an academic tourism center. Very nice.
Kojo, will this be bigger than what we have in Accra?
Yes, from all that we are hearing, it's bigger.
So this will be the biggest
150-acre land, and it's close to Dompase. I've mentioned this to you before. At Tonsu Dompase, where we had the landfill site, a lot of people complained that it wasn't being
well managed.
Yes,
so this is an upgrade. What about Tema? What's happened to Tema? Have they launched the project?
Yes, they said we're going to do something in Tema. We have to follow up on. But they've launched some in Sefri and other.
All right.
Areas.
So, Kuki, what's your main story? Asantehene talking to Nanado.
Yes, and just another note on this center, the recycling plant. It also comes with a restaurant, a clinic, a cafeteria, lecture halls, administration block, a conference hall, and other auxiliary facilities.
When? How long will it take to build?
No, it's done.
They finished
it. Yeah.
So they inaugurated it yesterday.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
Yeah.
All right. Still in Ashanti region.
Yes. The Ashanti region gets 1,824 projects. The president also has inspected work on the 500-bed military hospital. It was one of the hospitals.
Afari.
Yeah. And the Kumasi Airport project as well. Now, the story says that Asantehene Otumfo was 82 the second, has assured President Ekufuado that going into the December 7 presidential and parliamentary elections, his record in office will speak for him. Otumfo was 82 made this known when President Ekufuado paid a courtesy call on him at the Menchia Palace at the commencement of a 3-day working visit of the Ashanti region. Addressing a deba held in honor of the president, Asantehene thanked the president for his continuous visits to the Menchia Palace, both as a leader of the opposition before the 2016 elections and as the president of the republic. To this end, he stated that, quote, your good works will in office will speak for you going forward into the election. We in Asantiman remember, we do not forget. Asantiman will therefore remember your good works on election day. All I can offer you is prayers and blessings.
Okay.
And then a list of projects, mm-hmm. at least a summary of projects and, ongoing in Kumasi. 1,824 projects mm-hmm. ongoing in the Ashanti region. Out of this, 774 have been completed, with 1,050 still ongoing. And the president told the Asantini that there are 604 projects in the education sector, 92 in the health sector, 151 road projects, 606 in water and sanitation, and one in aviation and one in the ports. And on aviation, Kumasi Airport project is one.
Mm-hmm.
He went to inspect that, and he also went to inspect the 500-bed military hospital.
Okay.
Something else the president did while he was in Kumasi, he went to dinner alone. Listen to this. President mm-hmm. Dankwa Akufo-Addo mm-hmm. surprised many mm-hmm. as he stormed the Royal Park Hotel in Kumasi alone to have dinner on Sunday evening. This is in the Daily Guide. The first gentleman of the land, who is currently on a three-day tour in the Ashanti region, unexpectedly entered the restaurant of the popular hotel around 7:50 p.m. Surprisingly, the usual motorcades that follow the first gentleman of the land whenever he appears in public were missing. His hordes of bodyguards were also missing. He was accompanied by just one bodyguard. He quietly walked in and sat at the restaurant as he patiently waited to be served by the hotel personnel. His presence in the restaurant suddenly changed the atmosphere of the place as other guests became curious. Some people were craning their necks to catch a proper glimpse of the president, who, from all indications, was enjoying his meal.
You should have gone to pay for him since he's the first gentleman on
now, let me give you a story you don't have in the newspapers. Members of secessionist group allegedly attack STC, beat up drivers, burned down bus. This came in this morning. This is citynewsroom.com. A group of people suspected to be members of the separatist group advocating for independence from Ghana for the Western Togoland state has attacked the STC in the Volta regional capital Ho and set one of its buses ablaze. The incident occurred around 1 a.m. Monday, Tuesday. The members of the group reportedly fired gunshots before proceeding to beat up some drivers. There's currently heavy security presence at the scene, and we heard from our reporter earlier in the morning. This is the latest incident by the group pushing for whatever they are pushing for. On Friday, the group attacked and actually blocked major roads Accra to Sogakope, Accra, Joapong, and also besieged Aveime and Mepe police stations, freeing inmates and making away with assault rifles and shotguns. They also attacked the North Town District Assembly, made away with a Toyota Hilux pickup vehicle belonging to the district assembly. Now, there have been some commentary around this. Let me just bring those to you. For example, MPP says, let's join hands to condemn attacks by secessionist group. And this is John Buedu, general secretary of the party, spoke on Eyewitness News yesterday. He, at a news conference, he said, all political parties need to collectively show disapproval for the happenings that seem to attempt to circumvent the constitution of Ghana. And John Buedu also made the same point on Eyewitness News. Meanwhile, the NDC's Okudzeto Ablakwa says, stop the cheap politics and address Western Togoland issues. MP for North Town, Samuel Okudzeto Ablakwa, says the MPP government has failed Ghanaians by not adequately dealing with the threat of the secessionist groups. He said the government and the ruling party are rather engaged in cheap politics instead of acting decisively on the matter. Those are the issues with Western Togoland. We have an interview on that later on the show today. Kukui. Okay.
Yeah, the statement carries the same story, basically. MPP urges political actors to condemn separatist activities in Volta region. So it does, again, reference John Buedu's speech.
Mm-hmm.
And it also makes reference to the fact that the Volta Regional House of Chiefs also condemned the acts.
Then there's a last one here. Intridansu says there's a hidden agenda by persons involved in these acts. The Dean of Academic Affairs, Ghana Armed Forces Command and Staff College, Dr. Vladimir Chidanso, has questioned the motive of the secessionist group seeking to disintegrate the Volta region from Ghana. He made these comments after recent disturbances in the region. He told City News that the group does not meet any of the international criteria for secession. And then he quotes a few laws to backtrack his point.
There's an interesting story on the back page of the Ghanaian Times, and this is about local level governance.
Mm-hmm.
Assembly members advocate electoral area common fund.
Is it?
Yes. And Alberto Mario Noretti writes from Ho.
Noretti
writes from Ho that the progressive assembly members and former assembly members in the Volta region have called for the establishment of an electoral area common fund to enable assembly members undertake development projects in their electoral areas.
Mm-hmm.
They insisted that they were the true development agents in their communities and that such a fund would definitely enhance their development agenda.
Mm-hmm.
The chairman of the group, Mrs. Martha Gato Lagble, said at a press conference in Ho that putting assembly members on a payroll would also enhance local governance in the country.
Mm-hmm.
She said assembly members played numerous roles in the community, adding that the era when assembly members worked as sacrificial service renders should now become a thing of the past. Now, talking about assemblies and local area development issues, center spread of the Chronicle, Kitasi residents call for truce in dispute over construction of a 120-bed hospital. Now, the story says residents of Kitasi community in the Kapim South Municipality, which is located about 35 kilometers north of Accra, have called for truce over a standoff involving a 120-bed hospital. They have passionately called on the parties involved, particularly an estate developer whose name was not readily available at the time of filing this report, to rescind the decision of not allowing the chiefs and people of the area to continue with the project. And the story goes on to say that initial work has started with some structures constructed to store building material, but the estate developer says no, the land belongs to him, and he will not allow the chiefs and the people to build the 120-bed hospital.
All right, very quickly, on the back page of Daily Graphic, court remands 31 alleged secessionists. So just in reference to that, you can read more about that on the back page of Daily Graphic. 31 alleged members of a separatist group that blocked major entry points in the Volta region last Friday and attacked security personnel have been put before the Accra Circuit Court. The group, which include a female, were arraigned yesterday on provisional charges of attending a meeting of prohibited organization, conspiracy, participating in a campaign of a prohibited organization, and rioting. But then also quickly in the graphic, EC restores majority of missing names on register. The Electoral Commission has given an assurance that no eligibly registered voter will be denied the right to vote in this year's elections. In that vein, the Commission is doing everything possible to address all issues on the provisional voters register. The chairperson, Ms. Jean Mensah, who gave this assurance, said the electoral body had retrieved and restored almost all the names that went missing from the provisional register during the exhibition exercise. Additionally, the commission had updated its electronic register with the missing data and was doing due diligence within the electoral laws to ensure that the final voters register did not disenfranchise any person.
Meanwhile, IPAC is being urged to convene. Eminent Persons Group is telling EC to involve IPAC in every electoral process. Story on citynewsroom.com says the Christian Council of Ghana, Eminent Persons Group of Religious Leaders in Ghana, has urged the Electoral Commission to involve the Inter-Party Advisory Committee in every electoral process leading to the December 7 elections. Still on the EC, there's a story here that says December 2020 polls cannot be manipulated. Again, that story came up from an event at the Church of Pentecost headquarters. Electoral Commission Chairperson Jean Mensah has said systems have been put in place to ensure the December polls cannot be manipulated. She was speaking under the at the launch of the Church of Pentecost 2020 Agenda for Peace campaign on Sunday when she made this announcement.
Let's go back to the courts. Yesterday, there was a story that Kenny Japon couldn't show up in court because he was suffering from COVID-19-related complications. Now, page 3 of the New Crusading Guide, court summons Kenny Japon's doctor. Now, the story says that Accra High Court has summoned Dr. Ken Addo of the Holy Trinity Medical Center and Spa to appear before the court and explain the medical excuse duty he granted Kennedy Japon. This is after the MP failed to show up in court yesterday, September 28, 2020, due to what his lawyers describe as post-COVID-19 fears. Kwame Jan, the counsel for Kennedy Japon, explained to the court that the MP has been advised by doctors to take a 14-day rest. And he told the court, presided over by Justice Amos Wunta Wuni, that Kennedy Japon is suffering from post-COVID-19 trauma. Right.
Now, the governor of the Bank of Ghana has a few things to say to us. Yesterday, he maintained the policy rate, but also that was at 14.5%. That's the third consecutive time. Then the other story is that our debt stock is now up by 43.5 billion cedis. So Ghana's total debt stock has gone up again. According to the latest summary of macroeconomic and financial data from Bank of Ghana, the total public debt stock, which started the year at 219 billion, saw an accumulation of 43.5 billion in 7 months, bringing the total debt to 263 billion cedis. Now, the total amount of fresh debt accumulation in the first 7 months of the year is 28.9 billion. Now, I wanted to give you a story.
Let me give you one more follow-up on
okay.
What, and he's also predicting economic recovery of up to 2.5%.
All right, still from the same program yesterday.
From the same program, yeah.
Kokui, let's come to you.
We've got a couple of agric stories in the Business and Financial Times. Tree Crops Development Authority to be inaugurated today.
Yes.
President Nana Addo Dankwa Akufo-Addo will today, Tuesday, well, September 29th, inaugurate the much-awaited board of the Ghana Tree Crop Development Authority, TCDA, a body to regulate Ghana's tree crops in Kumasi. Like the Ghana Cocoa Board, this board will oversee the regulation of the production, processing, and trading of tree crops, cashew, oil palm, rubber, shea, mango, coffee, and coconut in Ghana. They'll also identify and develop sustainable sources of funding to promote and support the development of the tree crop industry. It'll be mandated to coordinate and facilitate to build the capacity of farmers, processors, traders, and exporters of tree crops, and to serve as a licensure body to actors of the tree crop value chain. Also, this one,
still on our Greek.
Still on our Greek, and I really hope we can discuss this one day. GMOs, all right? Let's embrace GMOs to transform agriculture. This is from CSIR CRI Deputy Director. The Deputy Director for the Council for Scientific and Industrial Research, Crops Research Institute, Professor Mrs. Marion Quain, has rekindled the call for the adoption of genetically modified crops to brighten the agenda of agricultural transformation to drive economic growth and development. She observed that with the rising agricultural production challenges, such as declining soil fertility, pests and disease infection, climate change, inherent low yields, and post-harvest losses, it is imperative to embrace the GM technology to enhance productivity, to ensure food security, and protect the environment as well. She also explained that the use of GM crops is like the conventional use of hybrid seeds, where any serious farmer has to buy seeds every season to remain relevant. Hopefully we can have a discussion on this in the future.
What I want to talk about is the harvesting of 600 bags of maize. This story is on citybusinessnews.com by Elenda Pai, and it says over 600 bags of maize harvested from city farms. Now, the management of City FM City TV has harvested over 600 bags of maize from 10 out of its 20-acre maize plantation in the Kwapim North District in the Eastern Region. The farming initiative, which is in partnership with Glofed Fertilizer Company, forms part of the station's commitment towards the Operation Feed Yourself campaign, which was launched last year to encourage people to consider agribusiness as a viable livelihood. So not only did the station organize a conference about entering agriculture, we actually started a farm. The farm manager, Perez Edunyame, explained to City Business News that what the harvest meant for the station in monetary terms as well as the journey so far. It says, we started the farming season in June. We had a serious armyworm infestation, which we tackled. A lot of people thought the farm wouldn't succeed. Thanks to Glofed Fertilizer, it actually yielded. We estimated about 6 metric tons per hectare, which gives us roughly 1,000 bags for the 20 acres or 50 kg bags. Right now, we've harvested less than half of the farm and we've exceeded 500 bags already. And as I said yesterday, the first Ewokpele must be released at City Kitchen from City Farms. And I'll be there. I'll do the honorable thing by launching it. From farm to cornmeal to gaze. Ewokpele. It will be keke.
Wait till the pepper is ready. Then you add the pepper to the maize and prepare your Ewokpele.
As you wait. City Farms Ewokpele. It will be rough.
This is the City Breakfast Show. The city's biggest conversation.
On every street, in every town, and all across.